At the beginning of the basket weave dishcloth pattern, there's an instruction at the beginning of every row that may be new to some people. And the instruction says yarn forward, YF, slip one purlwise, which is SL1P, and then yarn back, which is YB. So yarn forward, slip one purlwise, and yarn back. And this could be a little confusing to people because when you look at the work, on the very first stitch, you're supposed to have the yarn forward, but as you can see, the yarn is naturally forward in the first stitch of every row because when it was turned around this way and it was knitted, it forced the yarn into the back. So when you turn around the work and you're prepared to start the new row, what you're really supposed to do is this. Keep the yarn in front, slip one purlwise, which means you put in your needle into the front of the stitch and you pull it off. You pull the one stitch off. So now it's on the right-hand needle. And now it says yarn back. You haven't done anything with that stitch. You're just slipping it over onto the yarn, onto the needle, and you're putting the yarn between the two needles. So you have your yarn in the back now, so you can do a knit stitch, which is the next stitch, just like that. And what this stitch does is it creates this nice flat loop on the edge of the work. And that flat loop makes it so you can keep a nice finished line along the edge of your dishcloth, and it stays flat and it doesn't curl up. So that's how you do the first stitch of the dishcloth, and that's why the first stitch is a slip stitch, because it keeps the work flat, it creates the flat edge, and it makes it so it's a consistent edge all the way along the piece of work.